All right, we're on problem number 8, and they ask us which equation is equivalent to 5x minus 2 times 7x plus 1 is equal to 14x. So I'm guessing they just want to simplify this a little bit and see if we get to one of these choices. So let's do that. So we start with 5x minus 2 times 7x plus 1 is equal to 14x. Now this is, I think, the most obvious thing to simplify. This 2 times the 7x plus 1, or we could even say minus 2 times 7x plus 1. So then this becomes 5x plus, I'm just going to distribute the minus 2 times all of this, plus minus 2 times 17x is minus 14x, minus 14x, and then minus 2 times 1 is minus 2, is equal to 14x. And let's see, on all of these choices, they have 14x on the right-hand side, so they just want us to simplify this. So this simplifies to 5x, see, plus minus 14, so that's minus 14x minus 2 is equal to 14x. So we have 5x minus 14x. So what's 5 minus 14? It's what, minus 9, right? Minus 9x minus 2 is equal to 14x. And that is choice A. And one thing that maybe I realized, I kind of skipped a step. We could have just, let me just do this, just so that you understand this step that I did here. We could have just said minus and then distribute the 2. So we could have, right there, said 5x minus positive 2 times 7x, 14x, plus 2 times 1, plus 2. I'm just doing the left-hand side. And then we could have distributed the minus sign. So you get 5x minus 14x minus 2. Either way, it would have gotten us to this point, and then we could have simplified here and gotten choice A. Next problem. Which equation is equivalent to, okay, so another case where I'm guessing they just want to simplify it, want us to simplify these equations. So let me write that down. 4 times 2 minus 5x is equal to 6 minus 3 times 1 minus 3x. All right, let's distribute this 4 first. So you get 4 times 2 is 8. 4 times minus 5x is minus 20x. Minus 20x is equal to 6 minus, and I don't, maybe you might have been tempted to say, oh, 6 minus 3, and that's 3, and then distribute. Remember, order of operations, multiplication comes first, right? So we have to multiply the 3 times the 1 minus 3x before we can deal with the 6. And well, on the other side, there was just the multiplication first. All right, so here, 3 times 1 minus 3x, so it will be 3, I'm just going to do minus a positive 3 times each of this. So 3 times a negative 3 is minus 9x. And now I can distribute this minus sign. So let's see, on the left-hand side I have, let me do it in a brighter color. The left-hand side I have 8 minus 20x is equal to 6, and then I'm going to subtract this whole thing. So you can view it as distributing a negative 1 times both of these. So 6 plus minus 3, or just 6 minus 3, and then a minus times a minus plus 9x. Plus 9x. All right, now let's see what we could do to help simplify this. What happens if we add 20x to both sides? Then on the left-hand side, it goes away. So we're just left with 8 is equal to, well, let me just simplify. Well, let me just do that. 6 minus 3, I added 20x, so plus 29x. I really should have simplified this 6 minus 3, but I didn't want to do too much in one step. So 8 is equal to 3 plus 29x. And then if we subtract 3 from both sides, here we get 8 minus 3 is 5. That 3 goes away, and you get 29x. And that is choice C. 29x is equal to 5. C. Next question, problem number 10. And I should be careful that you don't think that all of this stuff is for this problem. The total cost C in dollars of renting a sailboat for N days is given by this equation. Okay. If the total cost was $360, for how many days was the sailboat rented? So they're giving us C. C is $360. So they're telling us that 360, that's the total cost, and that's going to be equal to 120 plus 60 times the total days rented. times 60N. And that's what they want us to figure out. N, how many days was the sailboat rented? Let's see. So if you subtract 120 from both sides of this equation, you get 240 is equal to 60N. And I'll go here. And if you divide both sides of this by 60, 240 divided by 60, that's the same thing as 24 divided by 6. So that's 4. And then 60N divided by 60 is, of course, 1. So that is N. So the sailboat was rented for 4 days. All right, problem number 11. Okay, and I cut and pasted part of it, but they want us to determine what was the first incorrect step that they did in this problem. So let's see if we can determine that. So let's see. Solve 3 times x plus 5 is equal to 2x plus 35. Fair enough. So in this first step, they distributed 3 times x, 3 times 5, right, 3x plus 15 is equal to 2x plus 35. So step 1 looks good to me. Let me do that in a darker color. Step 1 looks good. They distributed the 3. Now let's see what they did in step 2. Let's see. If I wanted to solve this, I would subtract 2x from both sides. And it looks like that's what they attempted to do. Because they got rid of this 2x, right? On the right-hand side, they went from 2x plus 35 to just 35. So somehow, they got rid of this 2x. And the only way to get rid of it is to subtract 2x from both sides. Right? Subtract 2x from both sides. Now, if I subtract 2x from both sides, sure enough, the right-hand side will just be left with the 35. The left-hand side will have the 15, of course. And then I have minus 2x plus 3x. Well, minus 2x plus 3x, that's x. So this 5x, shouldn't be there. It should be x plus 15 is equal to 35. So even though they were trying to get rid of this 2x, and they should have subtracted 2x from both sides, they inadvertently added 2x here. So they said 2x plus 3x is equal to 5x. Well, that was wrong. You have to subtract. And you're just left with x plus 15 is equal to 35. So step 2 is when they made their first error. Problem 120. A 120-foot long rope is cut into 3 pieces. The first piece of the rope, let me draw. This is begging for a diagram. All right, so they say the first piece of rope is twice as long as the second piece of rope. Okay, and then they say the third piece of rope is 3 times as long as the second piece of rope. Okay, everything is a multiple of the second piece of rope. All right, so let me. So the second one was the shortest one, just reading it, right? The first is twice as long as the second. The third is 3 times as long. So this is, so if I just drew it, so if this is the second length of rope, let's call that x, right? That's the second length of rope. And they told us the first piece of rope is twice as long as the second piece of rope. Okay, so if this is the first piece of rope right here, it's going to be twice as long as the second piece of rope. So that's 2x. Fair enough. And then they tell us, I'll do this in magenta, the third piece of rope is 3 times as long as the second piece of rope. So this is the third piece of rope here. It's 3 times as long as the second piece of rope. So it's 3x. And they say, what is the length of the longest piece of rope? All right, so let's think about it. If I add up all of these segments, right, what do they add up to? Well, they tell us that it's a 120-foot long rope. So let me add that up. So if I do 2x plus x plus 3x, that's going to equal 120 feet. That is equal to 120 feet, right? That whole distance is 120. So 2x plus x is 3x plus 3x, you get 6x. Is equal to 120. You divide both sides by 6, you get x is, 120 divided by 6 is 20. All right, that's what x is. That's the second long, that's the second piece of rope, or the shortest piece of rope, because they tell us that. The other ones are some multiple of that length. But they want to know, what is the length of the longest piece of rope? The longest piece of rope. Well, the longest piece of rope is clearly piece 3, right? It's 3 times the second piece. Piece 1 was only 2 times. So this is what they want to know. They want to know what 3x is equal to. So 3x is equal to 3 times 20, which is equal to 60 feet. And that's choice C. Next problem. Let's see if I have time. Yeah, I think I have time. Might as well attempt to fit it in. All right. Don't want to rush them, though. Let's see. Where? The cost to rent a construction crane is $750 per day plus $250 per hour of use. What is the maximum number of hours the crane can be used each day if the rental cost is not to exceed $2,500 per day? Okay, so how much is the cost per day? So the cost per day is equal to $750. So no matter how little or much we use it, we have to pay that $750 per day. So it's equal to $750 plus $250 per hour. So plus $250 times the number of hours. This is what our total cost is per day. And they want to say, what is the maximum number of hours the crane can be used each day if the rental cost is not to exceed $2,500 per day? So this whole thing has to be less than or equal to $2,500, right? The total cost has to be less than or equal to $2,500. So now let's just solve this equation right there. And I'll do it up here. So we know that 750 plus 250, let me do it down here actually, more space. So what's the first thing we could do here? We could subtract 750s from both sides of this equation. So we get 250 times h is less than or equal to 2,500 minus 750. That's what, 1,750? Right, yeah, because 1,500 minus 750 is 750. Right, 1,750, right? I just subtracted 750 from both sides of this equation. Let me write that down. Sometimes that I want to make, so I said minus 750 plus that, and then I said minus 750. And of course, minus 750 plus 750, that goes to 0. And that's why you don't see anything over here. And on the right-hand side, 2,500 minus 750 is 1,750. All right, now let's just divide both sides by 250. We don't have to do anything to the inequality sign since 250 is a positive number. So the hours, the maximum number of hours, the hours have to be less than or equal to 1,750 over 250, which is, let's see, 1,750 divided by 250. That's the same thing as 25. That's the same thing as 175 divided by 25. 25 goes into 175. What is that? I want to say 7 times. 7. 7 times 5 is 35. 7 times 2 is 14. Plus 3 is 17. Right. So h has to be less than or equal to 7 hours. And that is choice C. See you in the next video.